Hello everybody, this is Kashish Khurana and you are watching YTV's exclusive show, The Breaking Point. And today I will let you know about a recently established startup operating across the world, providing dockless bike sharing operations in Malaysia, Singapore, China and now in India. It also has the concern toward the environment and moving toward the sustainable development. It is none other than the Hexi Technologies, and today we have the team of Hexi with us. So please give the loudest possible round of applause as I acknowledge the presence of Ms. Yashonil Saini, Sales and Marketing Head, Hexi, and Mr. Prateek Garg, Senior Manager of Sales, Hexi. So welcome to our show. And first of all, I want to ask that, how are you feeling as you are representing Hexi in lovely professional university? So how are you feeling? How much you are excited?
LPU is a very exciting place to be. Even if you are not a student, even if you are not a faculty here, but then the vibe of this campus is so amazing that you can't just, you know, be here and be not affected by it. So we are definitely excited with what all we've seen, we've done, and even, you know, interacting with those students who are probably not using Hexi, but then they have so much of positive vibe in them. They're doing their own thing. They're very creative in whatever they are doing. So it's an amazing place to be. So we are very excited to be here.
So jab maine pehli bar Hexi ka naam suna, so I was not able to recognize that what is it all about. So Hexi hi kyun? Matlab koi idea nahi tha ki ek cycle hai. Jab pata chala ki haan Hexi ki ek cycle hai, tab hum वाकिफ हुआ इस बात से. तो हेक्सी क्यों इस कोई.
सो व्हाट वाज योर फर्स्ट गेस? आई मीन जस्ट टेल मी व्हाट वाज योर फर्स्ट गेस.
नो गेसेस, नो गेसेस.
सो इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल नेम.
वी डिडंट वांट टू कॉम्प्लिकेट थिंग्स. सो इट इज हीरो टैक्सी. इट्स अ पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट कंपनी. इट इज गवर्नड बाय हीरो. सो जस्ट जॉइन द नेम्स एंड देयर कम्स हेक्सी. सो हेक्सी इज आवर ब्रांड स्पेशली फॉर द नॉन एमिशन मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. And so it is Hexi. It is simple, sweet and smart. Yeah. And it makes you curious.
Yes, sure. And what do you want to say about the collaborations that Hexi have?
So it's a very exciting collaboration. It's a joint venture of Hero Cycles and our international partner, which is Yuon. So what happens when the largest cycling manufacturer joins hands with the biggest public bike share company internationally? So it leads to this consortium by the name of Hero Yuon Private Limited, where Hero is the leading partner and all the technological backbone is being taken care by the international partner Yuon.
Okay.
Yeah. So it sounds heavy, but then it's a very cool company.
So what motivated you to come to LPU?
Well, see, when we were thinking of the markets that we can target with the concept we have, so we targeted cities and campuses. So leaving aside cities for now, talking about campuses, there are two kinds of campuses. One is educational campuses and other is corporate campuses. And educational campuses, when we talk about educational campuses, then a campus like LPU LPU is the first campus that comes to mind. Because the sheer size of the campus, the number of students that you have, and
even though they are much excited about the new thing,
right. So and also, I don't think there is any other campus in India which is such huge and also close knit. So there are other campuses which may be bigger in terms of the area, but then they are open campuses, and which the control over our model becomes not that easy. So LPU was kind of an ideal choice for us, and that is why it was the first name to our mind.
And also, if you see, when you listen to the LPU anthem, the first line is "Badlenge
kal ko bhi aadhi volto."
Exactly. So, wo jo kal hai, wo kaise badlega? Agar hum log aaj badlenge. So the institute which has the motto of changing the future. उससे आइडियल इंस्टीट्यूट और क्या हो सकता है. Hexi का पर्पस इस कैंपस में आने का सिर्फ बाइक्स इंट्रोड्यूस करवाने का नहीं है. हम लोगों का जो पर्पस ये है कि व्हाट कैन वी एक्चुअली डू टू मेक एनी चेंज इन द फ्यूचर. सो यहाँ का जो क्राउड है, यहाँ का जो मैनेजमेंट है, इट इज़ मच मोर ओपन टू इंट्रोड्यूसिंग एनी न्यू आइडिया. बिकॉज यहाँ पर भी आई ऑलवेज से दैट LPU मोर देन यूनिवर्सिटी, इट्स लाइक अ स्टार्टअप इनक्यूबेटर. सो एवरी वन हैज़ दिस न्यू आइडिया एंड द मैनेजमेंट इज ऑल्सो ओपन टू इम्प्लीमेंट इट. सो आर सोल पर्पज ऑफ कमिंग टू LPU इज ऑल्सो टेस्टिंग दैट कैन वी मेक दैट डिफरेंस. So that's why LPU was our first choice to start off with our idea.
Even though LPU students are also creating these startups and they are, because as you saw the e-rickshaws, it is also the startup
exactly.
of LPU student. Yes. So they are much more excited. So aapne ek baat boli, usse ek shayari yaad aa gayi. Ki kaha hai ki mushkil is duniya mein kuch bhi nahi, phir bhi log apne irade tod dete hain. Ki mushkil is duniya mein kuch bhi nahi, phir bhi log apne irade tod dete hain. अगर सच्ची निष्ठा हो किसी चीज को पाने की तो सितारे भी अपनी जगह छोड़ देते हैं.
गुड गुड गुड.
तो LPU के अलावा और कहाँ कहाँ ऑपरेट कर रहे हैं इंडिया में?
वेल, वी आर अ स्टार्टअप एंड वी आर स्लोली ग्रोइंग. सो LPU वाज आवर फर्स्ट प्रोजेक्ट एंड इट हैज बीन ट्रेमेंडस विद LPU. नाउ वी आर स्लोली टारगेटिंग न्यूअर एवेन्यू. सो विशाखापट्टनम इज वन सिटी विच वी आर एंटरिंग. And it will be a big project for us, the whole of Vishakhapatnam. We plan to have more than 800 cycles there, sprawling over around 80 stations that we'll be building in Vishakhapatnam. So that is a huge project that we are having. And then we are also having some other educational projects in Punjab and other states as well. So slowly we are growing. So we, as of now, are in a startup and a growth phase.
So recently I saw the news that Hexi is also operating in Malaysia, Singapore, China, and now in India. So what do you want to say about your international relations of Hexi?
Well, our Hexi's present focus is India only. And the markets that you're talking about are there. We are operating through a JV there. But then as of now, our key focus area is India. Yeah.
Because it also supports Make in India.
Exactly.
Right. And then the thought of Hero Cycles is to make a change in India towards making mobility sustainable. So that is the key driver of our thought. And it is more towards changing the direction of Indian mobility. So the focus area is India only.
As you have saw, as you have seen that most of these startups, even 75% of these startups, they recently failed. Why? Because there were many challenges and they were not able to cope up with the obstacles, with the problems. So you would also have witnessed some problems, you would also have went through some problems. So could you justify some of the problems so that the newcomers, those who are planning for the startups, they could learn something from your startup?
See, though I personally believe that we are too young to give any advice, but yes, we have also faced many challenges because existing system mein, whenever you introduce anything new, so ek bada hi organic reaction hota hai, resistance. So for something like this, you know, a non-emission vehicle, bicycle, इस तरीके के concept को introduce करवाने में कई सारे challenges थे. There were some challenges from the authority side, there were some challenges from the market side. The biggest challenge is this idea successful? जो लोग बचपन में cycles चलाना छोड़ चुके हैं, can we make them use it again?
So attitude was the biggest hurdle. So to sum it up, attitude was the biggest hurdle. And second is the infra. So the Indian, so when we talk about bicycles, we don't have cycling lanes. So log kehte hain chalayenge kahan pe roads, agar roads pe chalayenge, roads are not safe. So infra doesn't support it. Third is weather. So it is hot and humid here. Cycle chalayenge paseena aayega, we will not be in the position to join our office or things like that. So ye sab obstacles hain, but then when we delved into it deeper, we saw that all the obstacles are surmountable if you have the will and if you know that this is the way forward. Agar sustain karna hai to aapko iski taraf badhna hi hai, there is no other choice. Then government will also support you, which we are receiving support from government. So cycling lanes dheere dheere aa rahi hain shehron mein. And people ke agar attitude ki baat kare to fir if you see now cycling lately, एक पहले इमेज होती थी गरीब आदमी की सवारी है साइकिलिंग, नाउ इट हैज़ बिकम अ लाइफस्टाइल प्रोडक्ट टू हैव. सो धीरे धीरे लोगों के एटीट्यूड में भी चेंज आ रहा है. सो विद टाइम वी बिलीव दिस इज अ फ्यूचर दैट विल डेफिनेटली बी यू नो रियलिटी सम टाइम.
बिकॉज इन दिस एरा youth are focusing more on new technologies.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Like certain new cars are introduced, bikes with very modern technology.
Flashy.
Yeah. So they're attracted toward those things. Yes. So what do you think that this cyclist startup would bring a change in their attitude or?
So we make bicycling flashy. So
the whole idea of promoting is to make cycling look cool.
And cycling is cool. I mean, it is a lot of fun. I mean, I love cycling. So it is my habit to cycle 30 minutes daily in the morning. So I think cycling is cool. There is no two ways about it. Cycling is cool. It is just there is something. If there is something that needs to be surmounted to communicate that, we will do that. But then cycling is cool. There is no two ways about it.
And also, if you see, we are introducing these. I'm not just talking about bicycle, I'm also talking about other modes of transportation, be it the e-rickshaw or any other non-emission.
Green alternatives.
The purpose of having it in your city or in your area is to solve a last mile or short distance commute problem. Now, if I have a bike, of course, it is very convenient. But can I take it from my home and drop it at the station? I can't do that. Of having a shared asset-based model commutation is to make you, you know, all free of any liabilities of having your own vehicle. So you pick a bike from your home and drop it at the station. It is not your responsibility to maintain it also. So you can have a bike, be happy with it, but then when it comes to short distance commute, this is one very easy, comfortable and economic mode of transportation which we are introducing. So we are very clear on what is our target audience.
So I would like to add more about the public transportation aspect of our business. So there is a very good saying that a person has said, I'm missing the name. So he says that a developed country is not one where the rich has many cars. A developed country is one where the rich uses public transportation. So that is a truly developed country. So when we talk about public transportation, now we have world-class metro infrastructure in multiple cities. Yeah. But then it is not really well received. So Lucknow has not picked up really that well. Gurgaon has not really picked up that really well. So people are used to convenience from home. They want a car from their bed for the car to reach to their office desk. So this is the convenience that people are used to. And metro station cannot come at your home. So there would be some distance from the metro station to your home. So this is the first mile. And then from the metro station to your office, that would be last mile. So this commute from your home to the metro station and likewise at the other end, the first mile and the last mile, this, if it eases, and if we are able to provide that kind of convenience to the consumer, then maybe he finds it more convenient that he can avoid the traffic that he faces while driving, and he uses the metro. So we can complement public transportation in our model.
As you have said that the cycles are also available in metro stations. Mm-hmm. So there are it is also available in Delhi metro station, but I don't think so anybody use that. Mm-hmm. Because whenever I see all those cycles are vacant, mm-hmm. and nobody is bothered to use that, and they only think that we are just going to travel in the auto rickshaw and we just go.
So it is a new concept, the challenges that we earlier discussed, that cycling lanes are not there.
Are you taking any initiative
attitude
to change their mindset?
Of course.
One of the key things which needs to be taken care in changing the mindset is doing something to change the mindset. So you must be seeing a lot of cycles around the metro stations, but do you actually see anyone coming to you and talking about using that cycle? That communication is not there. So how do I know that, you know, it is so comfortable, it is so economic, it is just lying there for...
There is no communication as of now with the audience. So communication has to be built up and a push would be required in the beginning. But then slowly, if people know the benefits, I'm sure they would love to.
They would love because people should also initiate this.
Yes.
Because this is an eco-friendly task.
Exactly.
And they should initiate it for the betterment of...
So there are multiple benefits. So eco-friendly, obviously, it is zero emission, zero carbon emitting a mode of transportation. That is obviously there. It is healthy. So with the kind of health problems that are this lifestyle, modern lifestyle has come up with, this is an healthy alternative. If you don't have time for exercising, no problem. While going to office and while coming back from office, you have this small 2 kilometers ride or 1 kilometer ride, and it can help you staying fit as well. and it doesn't bother your routine also. So there are benefits which have to be communicated, and we are working towards that.
So this all technology, you can tell me that where it is made, where it is assembled, manufactured?
Yes, so we will be manufacturing these cycles in India. So when we talk about public PBS cycles, public bicycle sharing scheme cycles, these are customized cycles. These are not the general cycles that one has for private use, because there are various safety mechanisms that have to be built in within the cycle. The technology has to be integrated with the safety mechanisms. So this technology was presently not, it is not presently available in India. So the cycles that we have presently have in LPU are imported ones. But then we believe in Make in India. Hero Cycles is the master manufacturer of cycles. So we are working on building prototypes and knowledge transfer with our international partners going on. And in future, we will be building cycles in India only.
Okay, so what would be your marketing strategy for future?
For us, bicycles are just a very small segment to begin with. Okay, so our focus is to have the eco-friendly mode of transportation in every city. So it is not just limited to bicycles, it is also going to be rickshaws, it is going to be electric scooters, it's going to be electric bus or electric bike, so to speak. So we are looking at a very large picture, because probably in LPU, bikes might be feasible, probably in other campuses it might be feasible. But if you look at a larger picture of a city requirement, of a country's requirement, then you need to have a very huge spectrum of products to approach that kind of problem. So our future target market segment would be anything and everything which has to deal with a non-emission, go green support mode of transportation.
Leaving that all about, I have personally used your cycle, bicycle, hexi cycle, and I truly enjoyed it.
Thank you.
And I want you to tell the audience that what technology you are giving to them in their cycles, because I have used, truly I have enjoyed a lot. That tubeless tires, opening with the app, scanning the code. So can you please elaborate some of the technologies that you are using in that?
Okay. So we give a platform for the users in which we have all the technology built in a mobile app, and that app can be downloaded in a phone, and a person registers, verifies his ID through Aadhaar, or when we are with institutes, then through the institute ID, etc. So he verifies himself, and then he can subscribe to any of the subscriptions that we have, so it be it monthly, be it annually, or be it daily plan. If he just wants to take for a single ride, he can subscribe to that ride. He goes to our cycle, scans the QR code through the app, the cycle automatically gets unlocked, and then he takes his ride and till wherever he wants to ride to, he enjoys his ride, and then he ends the ride. He goes to any station nearby and he ends his ride and through the mobile app, and that's it. He would be billed according to the ride time, and the charges, you would be knowing, are very nominal, as good as free. So that is how it is, and that is
a fantastic startup.
The mechanism is very user friendly. It is, the whole design is built keeping the user in the mind. So we want it to be a convenient way of mobility. So the convenience has been prioritized in every step. Yes.
Sure. Yeah, the idea is to keep it comfortable and economical. That's it.
And if we talk about startups are generally initiated to fill that gap which is in the society, to attain a perfect objective. So what is your gap? What do you see that this gap should be filled in the society?
See, I mean, if I talk about startups, then startup hota kya hai? Char diwane log hote hain aur ek ajwa sa idea hota hai. So our team was also like that. We looked at situation, we looked at existing transportation in a different way. When you see thing differently, only then you can come up with a solution. So hum log ke liye ek jo starting point tha of addressing the whole situation was, how do I make it more comfortable? Can I make it economical? Can I also look at a larger picture of doing something for the environment? Because I can even have like a regular scooter to solve the problem. Probably it would be even more, people would probably be more open to take it. But can I actually approach a bigger problem? Can I reduce the carbon count of my city? So hum log ka jo idea start hua, do teen larger points par tha. First is to make it simple, comfortable, economical, and also do your little bit in saving the environment. So that's why hum logo ne apna jo focus even for the future hai, we have kept it only till the non-emission mode of vehicles.
That is the very part that, because social issues we have to also focus on that.
So while doing all this and keeping the social issue of ecological sustainability in mind, one thing that we were sure of, that for anything to take off, it has to provide value to the user. So everything said and done, we had to ensure that we are providing some good value to the user for it to take off. So we engineered our product accordingly, and we are sure that the users at LPU have loved the product, the kind of response we have got here. So we hope it grows on the same pace.
Yeah, it would definitely grow, because the thing you are providing is really amazing. Everything has a competitor. Every startup has its competitor. So whom do you think is your competitor, your brand's competitor?
Well, I think since the market is so big, there is no actual competition. There are only co-players. So because in a field like this, not just a single player can actually make a difference. It has to be, there is a space for everyone.
So we would like to welcome a few competitors, because that would be in fact helping us.
Okay, it is an open challenge from Hexi Technologies that they are waiting for the competitors like.
Yes, because that would be even helping our country as well in towards sustainable mobility. So competition is not an issue. The market is huge, huge out there. It is like an ocean out there, and whatever you want to have, you have. So competition is not an...
But the benefit of competitor is this?
The benefit of competition will definitely be...
We increase our quality.
Yeah. Correct. So ultimate benefit will pass on to the end user. Yeah. So it is always nice to have competitions.
So what message you want to give to our youth, to the upcoming startups that they should take care of? What message you want to give them?
Well, first of all, for every startup, just having an idea is not the critical point. What's more important is to make sure that you implement that idea. Because for every startup, the challenges at the initial stage are going to be many. First, the acceptance of that idea, because usually they startup they usually come up with a very new concept. So making it acceptable for the market, it is also challenging when it comes to, those early stages. So the first few challenges I can maybe name, like funding would be one. Then public acceptance would be another challenge. And how do you sustain your model, business model? That is also going to be a big challenge. But given all the challenges, the only thing they should keep in mind is Datero.
So thank you for being with us, for being the guest of our today's evening. So this is the breaking point, that we have to move toward the sustainable development and follow the Go Green campaign. We all strongly agree that it is the moral responsibility for every citizen to save our environment. But what the scenario is, we all know about that. But it's the right time of paying back to our mother nature. Paying back in terms of saving power, or paying back in terms of saving water, paper, fuel, or all types of natural resources that are contributing to global warming. And cycling, yes, my friends, cycling would be the best mode of paying back to our mother nature. So let's join this campaign and make a change in our environment. So this was The Breaking Point with me, Kashish Khurana. So stay tuned with us and keep watching YTV.